passionate speaker hoping to help audience to gain a new insight about a common yet critical resource. The title of Zhu Yan's speech tonight is Water, an Overlooked Resource. Zhu Yan, Water, an Overlooked Resource. Water, an Overlooked Resource, Zhu Yan.
Ladies and gentlemen, do you keep track of your water usage at home?
Yes.
This morning, when I looked at my water bill, I realized that I have used 19 meter cubes of water this month, just under the 20 meter cube limit for which the Selangor government subsidizes our water bills. As a result, the only payment I need to make to the water company is just 20 cents. Compared to the price of petrol, which has just increased by 20 cents per liter 2 weeks ago, water doesn't seem to be as valuable as what we consider to be oil that's pumped up from the ground. Or is it? 97.5% of the water in this world are in the oceans. Only 2.5% are the fresh water that we can use. Of this 2.5%, a large proportion of it is contained in the glaciers and the ice caps of Antarctica. Useless words. You can't use it. Only 0.3% of this fresh water are in our rivers and lakes readily available. Some are slightly harder to get. Groundwater, underground. If the world's water are contained in this 1 liter water bottle, we will only have one drop's worth of river water, lake water, and one teaspoon's worth of groundwater to be used. Here in Selangor, most of our water that we use in our homes came from the Selangor River. And rivers, as we know it, are very fragile. On the eve of our 56th Independence Day, 30th August this year, can you all remember what happened? An overturned oil tanker spilled diesel into the Selangor River, affecting 1 million residents of Klang Valley, including me. As a result, the water supply to my house was cut for 2 days. If one overturned oil tanker caused such great disruption to our water supply, imagine what would be the consequences if we allow greater pollution to occur to our rivers. The problem doesn't stop with the pollution, with water pollution. The water resource itself is gradually diminishing as well. Although we might think that we do not use much water in our homes, please bear in mind that domestic water use is but the tip of an iceberg of the total water usage. In Malaysia, only 11% of our water is used in our homes. Another 13% is used in businesses, in industry, and a staggering 76% is used in agriculture. This shouldn't be surprising at all, actually. To produce 1 kilogram of rice, our staple food, requires 3,000 liters of fresh water. And even though a large proportion of this water is obtained through rainfall, the increasing use of irrigation in agriculture has dramatically increased water withdrawal from our rivers. the situation for us is not all gloom and doom. Malaysia is blessed with abundant water resources, thanks to our tropical climate, which grants us 3,000 millimeters of rainfall annually. This constantly replenishes the water that's being drawn from the rivers. And this is also the reason why we only need surface water, water from our lakes, from our river, to meet our demands. Whereas in some countries, such as the United States, they are already depleting their groundwater resources, which are not renewable, as they take a very, very long time, perhaps thousands or millions of years, to be replenished by rainfall. Moreover, Malaysia has substantial groundwater resources which are untapped. So with proper management and development, Malaysia would never ever need to worry about a water crisis. Ladies and gentlemen, I hope you have gained a new insight about this precious liquid that sustains life on Earth. Now, please excuse me as I'm feeling thirsty after talking such a long time, and I would like to have a drink. Thank you.
Thank you for the insightful speech, Suyen.